Good morning and welcome on a Monday morning. Today's topic, Consumer Protection Act 1986. Again, a gist of it, what does Consumer Protection Act say? All of you know that consumer is a king and all the traders and the merchants and the big showrooms, everyone treats the customer as a king. They explain everything to us very nicely and see to it that we buy their products. When there is a dispute, when there is something, there is a damage in the goods or there is a discrepancy in the service that they give us, then we have to go to the consumer forum. So when we go to a consumer forum, how do we know where we have to go? Of course, we have to look into the jurisdictions. Each area will have a consumer disputes redressal forums. So that there is no need to know so much about it. But on what grounds can we approach the district consumer forums? It is damage of goods, damage to goods. See, we are supposed to have the goods in good order when we buy until it gets transported to our place and also when it is installed. Suppose there is a little slight damage or something when we get it in our house or in our office or wherever it is, when it gets delivered to us. In that case, we can very well approach the seller and tell him about the damage in goods. And in case of electronic goods or electrical goods, we will not get to know about it until we use it. So say, for example, very common example, TV. If we are buying say 55 inches, so many other inches are all there. When we buy those TVs, to look at it will be very nice. When we go to the showroom and see all those TVs, it looks very nice. But probably during the transportation, there has been some small problem, you know, because of the hump or the ditch or whatever it is. So if there is a little problem, then we can always approach the seller. It is not important that we should immediately approach the consumer disputes redressal forum. We can first talk to the seller, tell him about it. If the person does not respond properly, then we have to send a legal notice and then approach the district consumer redressal forum. Okay, so this is as far as goods are concerned. It can be a small damage, it can be the goods itself has been damaged, right? So, or probably if it is an electronic or electrical item, it is not working properly. Even then, it amounts to damaged goods. So it is not necessary that it should be, you know, broken somewhere, it should have a scratch somewhere. It's not necessary like that. For whatever purpose we have purchased the product, if that purpose is not being done by that particular purchased product, then it is said to be defect. Okay. So defect in goods is one ground on which we can approach the consumer forum. Then next we come to the services. Suppose I take up a room in a resort or a hotel or something like that, and when I look at the website, that's how we book nowadays, right? So I look at the website and all sorts of facilities are given, and looking at the facilities and all the promises that those people have made, I book a room in that particular hotel or resort or wherever it is. And suppose whatever are the benefits which are available to me, whatever are the facilities which have been promised to be given to me, if they are not given to me, then it would amount to deficiency of service. One thing, whatever has been promised, those facilities are not provided to me. And the second one is, if the facilities are provided to me, but there is some discrepancy in those services, you know. Probably if I have got the, say, facility of a conference room, okay, and I get the conference room, I am able to conduct the meeting in the conference room. But what happens during the meeting? The mic goes off. Or maybe the lights are all blinking. Something like that, you know, which causes disturbance. And when they promise that a perfect setting would be there in the conference room, it is not there. So even though it is a technical glitch or probably the bulbs have to be changed or whatever, it is the duty of the hotel to see that everything is as promised. So if their purpose is not served, then also I can approach the Consumer Disputes Redressal Forum. See, the District Consumer Redressal Forum is the first court which we have to approach in case of consumer disputes. In case it is not, see, the judgment may be in favor of us, may not be in favor of us. Just because it is not in favor of us, we cannot go on appeal. But suppose on just grounds, on fair grounds, the order is not in favor of us and we have sufficient evidence that it should be in favor of us, and we have, it is as per law, you know, that we go on appeal to the higher court. So when it is not, when we have to go on appeal from the district forum, we go to the state commission, whichever state we belong to, there will be a state commission. And from there we have to go on appeal to the national commission if need be. Usually everything gets solved in the district consumer forum because we have very